5G relies on spectrum to get from one place to another. And spectrum is just a fancy word for airwaves. Airwaves that are used for a bunch of different things. And who gets these airwaves influences how people and devices communicate.
Everything from telecom services like our cellular networks, to national security, to public safety and things like even weather forecasting.
That's Margaret Harding McGill.
I'm a tech policy reporter for Axios. Spectrum is like real estate. They're not making any more of it.
Point is, there's a finite amount of spectrum, so you need to either buy a license or share with someone else. Let's break this down.
Now, there are three main types of spectrum, and each type has its own characteristics.
Number one, low band spectrum.
Now, these travel great distances, but they don't carry a lot of traffic.
Up next is mid-band spectrum.
This is kind of the Goldilocks of spectrum.
It was just right.
And then there's high band spectrum.
These airwaves can carry a lot of traffic very quickly, but they don't travel very far. And things like trees, leaves, and even rain or fog can slow them down. So if you want some of this spectrum, generally you gotta get a license for it. And the licenses are held by the Federal Communications Commission. They sell the licenses to the highest bidder, and that money then goes to the Treasury. In the last few years, FCC spectrum auctions have raised billions for the Treasury.
So, who wants to pay for all that spectrum?
I go once, twice.
Short answer, exactly who you would expect.
Companies like Verizon and AT&T and T-Mobile all want new airwave licenses for 5G networks. In the meantime, cable companies like Charter or Comcast, they're also interested in spectrum. And then you have government agencies that are already using the spectrum for a host of different functions, from the military using it for radar to the National Weather Service using it for forecasting.
Across all of the spectrum bands, commercial interests are competing with government interests.
For example, you have the Department of Defense, which is very concerned that the FCC is allowing a company to use some spectrum for a potential 5G service. And the Department of Defense is scared that this 5G service will cause interference with GPS. And so that sets up some tension with national security.
The FCC is also fighting with the Department of Transportation over airwaves for autonomous vehicles. Now, the FCC did put aside some spectrum for autonomous vehicles years ago, but we still don't have them. So now cable companies, backed by the FCC, want to use that spectrum for Wi-Fi, but the Department of Transportation disagrees.
The Department of Transportation says we need this spectrum because once these connected vehicle communications get off the ground, they can save lives. And if that's not enough, there's another fight going on, and it's between the FCC and NOAA, the weather agency.
NOAA is worried that using another spectrum band for 5G will affect their ability to predict the weather, meaning that we might not know when hurricanes or tornadoes are coming.
And the FCC says, we know that this spectrum can be used for 5G without causing interference to these satellites.
So the bottom line is the spectrum is a limited resource and the FCC generally controls who gets it. And there are a lot of people who want it, from government agencies to companies like AT&T.
And who gets it and how they use it is important because it will determine the future of our communication networks and the services from Wi-Fi to 5G to even autonomous vehicles that you and I will have now and in the future.